Hello and welcome to another episode of Cooking with Mr. V. Today we are going to try something new and different that I have never done before. And that is something that I can barely pronounce. I think it's called a charcuterie board? Charcuterie board? Something along those lines. But basically what you need, kids, is to get a board and then you just put a whole bunch of stuff on it. And so that's what we're going to do today. Looking around, I don't have a board, so instead I'm going to do mine on a pizza board here. So it's going to be like a pizza charcuterie board. And I was trying to think like of a theme and what I wanted to do, and I thought, you know, with the nice days that we've had recently, it really got me itching to go camping. So we're going to do kind of an outdoorsy kind of camping theme. This is something that I hope that would be maybe appetizing for you for lunchtime. So, to begin with, what I did is I took some funnels and I went and I molded some mac and cheese, and I thought, you know what, this would be like nice little mountains or volcanoes for my charcuterie board. I'm gonna put one in each corner. So this is gonna kind of frame it. And I thought, you know, if you have four people here, what a great way to just get a little bit of mac and cheese in you during this time. The next thing that we have are some hot dogs, because we're now going to kind of set up the charcuterie board with kind of our campfire. And I thought, you know, if we just take these hot dogs, slice them up into little rounds, they might look like those little stumps that you can sit on around the campfire. And I thought, who doesn't like little hot dog pieces? So I thought, well, let's just put some around here like this, and we can make some nice hot dogs, little campfires that we're gonna get going here. What I find now that I'm finally doing this charcuterie board is that it's probably best to have a plan going into this. I don't. I'm just kind of doing this off the top of my head. I kind of have an idea of what ingredients, but I have no idea. I didn't even lay it out before I decided. So anyways, I have now some pretzels that I thought would work great as like logs, and they can go in the middle of these campfire rounds. Now it looks like the people sitting on these logs might be sitting a bit close to the campfire. I'm probably gonna get burned. That's okay. And my fire isn't quite as nice as I thought. Maybe I'm rushing it a bit too much here. I really don't know how long you're supposed to take to make one of these things. My thought is it should be pretty quick because you're just chucking a bunch of stuff on there, but who knows. And then I thought, okay, so we got our campfire, but it's not lit. So then I thought, well, let's take a little bit of the dried cranberries here and throw them kind of in on top here, and that can act like our flame. So now we got our flame going. And then I thought, okay, what else do we need? Well, it is outdoorsy, and let's try to get a little bit of health in here. So I got some trees. Now, how on earth are we gonna stand these up? Or do we just let them lie down? You know, for my board, I'm gonna let them lie down. They've fallen over, there's some clear cutting going on, knocked all the trees down. And so, yeah, I mean, I'm sure anyone else who wanted to take a little bit more time and patience probably would try to get them standing up. But for me, oh, this is taking too long. I'm just gonna lie them down here. And I like to do groups of three, I guess, only because of the space I got. And so, next thing I think about when I think about camping, I think about trails and going hiking. And so I thought, okay, well, I got the length here. So why not let's make a path using pocky sticks as kind of like into, well, maybe move that tree a bit, into my campground. I guess all we need is, I guess this is a charcuterie board for four. So I'll put four pocky sticks. And then I thought, well, let's make the trail, let's line that trail with some sesame seeds, or sunflower seeds, I should say. So then we got it going on in there. And that just gets lined down like that. There we go. And maybe we can actually take this. Oh, I like this idea now. See, now we get going and now we think, okay, now I can actually add some more. Let's make this trail go right through our campground and we can kind of push that off to the side a bit. Hell, the way log. There we go. We can add some more into here. Got this nice trail going on. And then you can add a couple more to get all the way to the other side of where we're going. Oh man. There we are. Let's push that campfire over a bit. And then push this tree over, put those trees there. And then maybe I can like break one up like that. Pick another one up like so. And there we have like a little trail. I don't know if I got enough sunflower seeds to do it, but we'll give it a shot. There we go. Maybe I put too many down here. Kind of bring it on over. So yeah, my charcuterie board, I really like the theme I got going on here. I think it's a good theme. I think we got some tasty stuff happening here. The only thing that we're kind of missing, and you probably are noticing it on the table here, is condiments, because I, for one, like a little bit of ketchup with my hot dog and with my Kraft dinner. So I thought maybe instead of mountains, let's just take a little bit off the top here, make kind of a hole in it. And now we don't have a mountain. Now we got a volcano. And who doesn't like a good volcano, right, for lunch? So let's just rip that off. And here are four volcanoes. All right. And then just take that off to the side. Get our ketchup going. This is going to be our lava. We can just make sure you shake it first. Don't want weak ketchup in there. And then we can just shake it in and have it like, woo, just head on down. Just like as if it was actual lava coming out. Doesn't that look good? Oh yeah. And just bam. Explosion. And there we go. So we have these lava kind of, maybe a bit more here, coming down. But nobody really wants to dip their hot dogs. So let's just get another maybe thing of dip here. Throw that in. Got one there. And then some people, they like mustard with their hot dogs. So let's get some mustard in there. Squeeze that in. Boom. We can throw that. I'm running out of space. Maybe right beside the ketchup in between these campers here. There you go. So this is my charcuterie board. It's a camping theme. I think it's very appetizing. I think any kid at lunchtime, if they came home and saw this, they're thinking, dig in. Like, this is fantastic. You got your KD, you got your hot dog, some pretzels, and the healthy broccoli. What more could you ask for? So, there you got it. Mr. V's charcuterie board. All right. So, just to prove that kids will eat this, I've asked my daughter and son to come and give it a try. So, kids, what do you think?
Yeah, good.
Why don't you give it a try?
I will not eat that.
One, two, three, go.
And now I'm done with that.
Let's do the Pockies.
Yeah, I'm doing Pocky. Or...
Hello and welcome to another episode. And here we are again. It's been several weeks since we first started our remote learning. All right, I gotta start over. Let me try this again. It's okay. You can see, stay recording.
I was gonna toot.
So. Okay. Just leave it. Here you go. Oh boy.
Like you have allergies
a bit,
but from far back
to okay.
Okay.
Hello and welcome to another episode. This is our 8th episode. That means we've been doing this now for just over 8 weeks. And I never would have thought that we would be here together shooting yet another weekly episode. I decided to go with more of a lumberjack look here, as that's how I feel with this awful beard that I have going. Although, I will say that it is still a great reminder of me thinking of you and praying for you, because every time I get itchy with it, I am thinking of you and thinking, okay, this is why I'm growing it. It's my prayer beard. I need to think of the students of St. Bernadette's. And for that, I'm grateful. But I can't wait for the day where I finally get to shave this off. And it's either going to be when you return back or the last day of school before we head out on summer break. But either way, you know what I'm going to do? I'm going to videotape it and I will make it part of my final episode so you can watch me rid my face of this beard and my hair. Look at this, like super long hair. It is crazy long. I cannot wait to get a haircut. I got wings coming out my sides. My hair is super long at the back. It's, I don't know. It's just crazy, crazy, crazy. So once again, we got another fun episode for you. Once again, you're gonna be able to see all your friends and people from other grades in this episode. We are gonna be putting a call out for people to submit videos for the year-end talent show. So if you have a talent and you would like to be part of our show, you need to take a video, make sure it's under 2 minutes, and send it off to me, and then I will be putting it all together and we'll be distributing that towards the end of June. So be on the lookout for a letter going home talking to you about that. In the meantime, I want you to enjoy another episode. So we have a lot of birthdays happening this week. I want to wish a happy birthday to Adrian in grade 1. He's still in the Philippines, so I hope that he is having a great birthday in the Philippines with his family. On the same day, happy birthday to Miss Mello. The very next day, I would like to wish a happy birthday to Miss Simic. Happy birthday to you. And Anna in kindergarten celebrates her birthday towards the end of the week, along with Logan in grade 6, so happy birthday to you. I wish you all a very special, blessed, wonderful birthday. I hope you're able to spend it with your family and have a great time. Enjoy your day.
watch how things will get brighter. Ooh, child, things are gonna get easier. Ooh, child, things will get brighter. Someday, yeah, we'll put it together and we'll get it undone. Someday, when you hit it much lighter.
And so there ends another episode. I'd like to thank you all for watching the episode with me today. And for my parting thoughts this week, I'm thinking a lot about sounds, especially nature sounds, as I'm kind of experiencing deer coming into my backyard now more often, the occasional bear, and just being able to wake up to the sounds of birds. It's amazing how sound works. That sound is actually physical, like the waves are actually entering into your body and hitting your eardrum. The sounds you hear is taking a physical approach to you. And so when we think about that and think about how sound works, we need to be careful of the sounds that we bring into this world. We have to be careful of the words that we use, how we talk to each other, how we express ourselves, express our feelings and our emotions. We have to be careful of the sounds that we make. And so I invite you to start thinking about that. Start thinking about sound and how sound affects us and how it affects others. Start thinking about sound in terms of silence. When in your day are you able to just sit in a moment of peace and silence? Think about, you know, how the Bible says that when Jesus met Elijah up in the mountain, it wasn't through wind or fire or an earthquake or anything like that. It was through a still, small voice. In other words, it was through silence. God comes to us in the quiet moments. So the more that we can find times to be silent and reflective, the closer we can perhaps find ourselves with God. So take some time and start thinking about sounds, start thinking about how sound is affecting you and how your sounds are affecting others, and take a moment of silence and maybe just go outside early in the morning and listen to the nature, listen to the sounds of the busy cars maybe driving by. Just that ambient sound that's around, or try to find a place in your home where you can have peace and quiet. So on that note, have a great week, and I look forward to seeing you again next week. Take care. God bless.